Now, you've heard of Pacamara coffee beans, right? But did you know these bad boys are absolute units in the coffee world? We're talking beans that can stretch up to 25 millimeters long. That's nearly double the size of your average coffee bean. But size isn't everything, right? Well, in this case, it kind of is. Let's get into the nitty-gritty of where these beans came from. It all kicked off in 1958 in El Salvador. Folks at the Salvadorian Institute for Coffee Research had this brilliant idea to cross two coffee varieties, Pacas and Maragogipe. Pacas, a natural mutation of the Bourbon variety discovered in 1949, was a tough little plant. It could churn out coffee even when conditions weren't ideal. On the other hand, you had Maragogipe, a typica variant from Brazil. This one was known for its massive beans and knockout flavour, but it was a bit rubbish when it came to yield. Now, creating Pacamara wasn't a quick job. It took these coffee scientists nearly 30 years of painstaking crossbreeding and selection. That's right, 3 decades of coffee science to get it just right. The result? A bean that combines Pacas' resilience with Maragogipe's exceptional taste. It's like the best of both worlds, isn't it? Now, let's get into the specs of these plants, shall we? Pacamara trees are medium-sized with thick foliage, short internodes, and leaves that are larger than your average coffee plant. They thrive at altitudes between 1,200 to 1,800 metres above sea level. That's about 3,900 to 5,900 feet for those of you still clinging to imperial measurements. Now, growing Pacamara isn't all sunshine and rainbows. These plants can be right temperamental. About 10 to 12% of Pacamara plants can revert back to the Pacas variety. It's like they forgot who they are and decided to go back to their roots. This means farmers have to be on constant lookout, monitoring their crops to maintain the Pacamara characteristics. Now, let's talk yield. Pacamara plants are known for being a bit stingy with their cherries. They produce fewer than other varieties, but here's the kicker. The cherries they do produce are typically twice the size of regular coffee cherries. It's quality over quantity, shabbers. Now, onto the good stuff, flavour profiles. Pacamara beans are known for their complex, multifaceted taste. We're talking a medley of fruity, floral, and nutty notes all dancing on your palate. Some cuppers report tasting citrus, red berries, and even chocolate. And for the adventurous tasters out there, some swear they can detect notes of jalapeno pepper jelly. I know, sounds mental, but in the world of specialty coffee, anything's possible. The complexity doesn't stop there. Pacamara beans are famous for their intense aromas, thanks to their high altitude growing conditions. They typically have a medium to dense body, creamy texture, and an elegant acidity that coffee snob and mean enthusiasts go crazy for. Let's geek out a bit about processing for a bit. Traditionally, Pacamara beans were fully washed, giving a clean, sometimes spiced taste. But in recent years, producers have been experimenting with all sorts of funky processing methods. We're talking natural processing, honey processing, and even anaerobic fermentation. Take the folks at Deterra Estate, for example. They've been pushing the envelope with techniques like natural process on the tree, they call it raisin, natural processing on raised beds, and various anaerobic methods. Each of these techniques brings out different aspects of the Pacamara's flavour profile. Now, all this special treatment means Pacamara beans often come with a price tag that'll make your wallet weep. But for many coffee aficionados, it's worth every penny. These beans have been cleaning up at competitions like the Cup of Excellence, where they're judged on things like aroma, acidity, body, flavour, and balance. But it's not all rosy in Pacamara land. Climate change is giving the coffee farmers sleepless nights. Those perfect high altitude conditions that Pacamara loves, they're under threat. Rising temperatures could push the ideal growing zones even higher up the mountains, potentially affecting both quality and quantity of the yield. There's a lot of research going on to make sure that we can keep enjoying these unique beans for years to come. Let's talk brewing, shall we? If you're lucky enough to get your hands on some Pacamara beans, you'll want to do them justice. These beans shine with a light to medium roast. Go too dark and you'll lose all those complex flavours we've been drooling over. As for brewing methods, Pacamara is pretty versatile. Want to bring out its vibrant acidity and broad flavour spectrum? Try a pour over or a chemex. Fancy a fuller bodied cup, French press or cafetiere is your friend. Just remember, with beans this special, precision is key. Pay attention to your water temperature, grind size and brewing time. Get it right and you'll be rewarded with a cup of coffee that'll make your taste buds do a happy dance. So there you have it, the deep dive into Pacamara coffee beans. From their birth in a Salvadorian lab to their rise as the darlings of the specialty coffee world, these beans are proof that sometimes good things come in big packages. They're a testament to human ingenuity, agricultural expertise, and our never-ending quest for the perfect cup of coffee. Next time you're feeling adventurous and your wallet is feeling generous, why not give Pacamara a try? Your taste buds might just thank you for it. And hey, you'll always have plenty to bang on about at your next coffee meetup. Remember, in the world of coffee, there's always something new to learn, always another flavour to discover. So keep exploring, keep tasting, and most importantly, keep enjoying, because at the end of the day, that's what great coffee is all about.